A young artist learns a hard lesson about fame.
I started producing for drug dealers, pimps, thugs.
Until he came face to face with his reality.
They came in with automatic weapons, had all my guys laid down.
I'm getting ready to put a hit out on somebody.
Find out how Canton Jones went from bad boy to gospel great on today's 700 Club Interactive.
On 700 Club Interactive, we use technology to pray for each other and explore topics that matter to you. Watch what God is doing in the world today.
Well, welcome to the program. Canton Jones has worked with such artists as John Legend, Patti LaBelle, Kurt Franklin. As a Grammy-nominated artist and producer, Canton learned that success meant creating music his mother can listen to. But that's a lesson he had to learn the hard way.
I'm a man of God, husband, I'm a father, I'm a brother. I feel like young people, they just need to know that the coolest thing to be is a man and woman of God. The Bible talks about we overcome by the word of our testimony. I'm from Florida, Deerfield Beach, Florida, in between Boca Raton and Fort Lauderdale. Down south. I have four other siblings with a father in the home. Grew up with a mom that didn't play, but she was very fun. You know, we had a lot of fun. We spent a lot of time in church. So you kind of have that perspective where you, you know, you do the church thing, you know, and you know what to do not to get caught. When I got to college, it was like I'm free from home. Nobody to tell me anything. I'm a grown man. I'm gonna do what I wanna do now. And I remember when I came to Atlanta, I strayed away from church. I didn't wanna do church. And really one of the main reasons why I didn't wanna do church is because I took to a certain type of music at that time, which was hip hop and R&B. And I felt like that music had no place in the church. So I had this big plan, you know what? Go out here, sell a bunch of records, come back, get my money to the church. And then when I'm getting ready to, you know, settle down, I come back and do some gospel CDs. I opened up a studio off campus, you know, to make some extra money and just really just try to follow this dream. I started producing for drug dealers, pimps, thugs, just different people. But those words, after producing this music every day, those words start to infect your spirit. My rule was, man, I don't want to make any music that my mom can't listen to. That was my rule. And then it was, okay, well, all right, you know, he said this, we'll let that go this time, you know, because he paid his money. Then it was like, okay, the more money they came with, the more I was willing to compromise. Because I thought, okay, this guy here knows this producer, or this guy can get us in contact with this guy and send your demo into this guy. And he was chasing this dream. And just perversion getting more and more into your spirit. And going through that process, man, I learned a lot, made a lot of crazy decisions. Through that, it wasn't enough to get me to change my mind about what I was doing. One situation, our studio, somebody came in. They came in with automatic weapons, had all my guys laid down, you know what I'm saying? Because they were looking for someone who wasn't there. Well, I wasn't there, but it was a mistaken identity. They thought we were doing a session with somebody, one of their enemies. And a lot of countless situations where I could have lost my life. I had just become a person that I wasn't proud of. Then I finally just came to the fact of, after being paranoid, having my studio broken into, I remember we had an idea of the guys that broke into the studio, that stole the equipment. And I called all my guys, man, y'all need to meet me down to the studio right now. And they came. And at that point, with four or five guns in the room, I had guys that were willing to take other guys' lives. And I was like, this is just, man, I'm a church boy, man. Why in the world am I? I'm getting ready to put a hit out on somebody. And I'm like, how did this happen? You know? And I remember, you know, in tears, I told the guys, go home.
go and call you later. And I couldn't do it. And that's when I felt like it had gone too far. There's one time, you know, my wife took me to this church called World Changers. And I started listening to the word. And, you know, when I heard Pastor Creflo Dollar, when I came in, he was teaching on the righteousness of God. And he said some things that night that really changed my life. But when you've done a lot of stuff that you're not proud of, you feel like, man, God don't want me. And when he started talking about it's not by your works, but you get in because of Jesus. You know, if you accept Jesus, that's how you get in. Not necessarily by the good things that you do, because you can't work enough to get yourself into heaven. You got to accept Jesus. And it became so clear. I don't want everybody to think you get saved and then the next day you're just on fire for God. You're laying hands on the sick and, you know, and I'm doing what I'm doing now at that time. No, it was a slow grind. Just built my character over time and over years so that there's not just this guy that just comes out of nowhere and then it's whatever happened to Canton Jones. No, you know, this is something that God is building. We're building something together. Family, we're building a relationship. I'm building a relationship with God. I'm building a relationship with my wife. I'm building a relationship with my pastors, with other people that's really meant something to me over these years, more than my career, more than my music, you know, those relationships that I can always go back to and confide in those people.
God wants to redeem his children. Now here's Canton, and he's saying, what am I doing here? I'm a church boy. How did I get to this position where I'm actively, there are guns in the room, and there are my friends in the room that are willing to take somebody's life? And that's when he said, I don't have any business being here. Now, what were the steps that got him to that position to say, okay, I have gone so far away from what I really believe that I'm in a room with people who are seriously thinking about taking somebody else's life, all because they broke into my studio and they stole some gear. I'm now thinking about killing people. You know, it's the old proverb, if you will, that if you put a frog in hot water and you just gradually increase the water, sooner or later that frog's gonna boil and he's not gonna know enough to jump out. There was something about that boiling water in that room right then when Ken said, I gotta get out of here. But what were the steps that got him there, and why did it take that to finally say, I need a turnaround? You know, it was very gradual. You know, here he goes into the music business and, you know, he knows that from the get-go, he's going to be exposed to things that he shouldn't be exposed to. But he says, okay, I'm just going to create music, and here's my pledge. I'm going to create music that even my mother will be good. It'll be good for her. She'll be able to listen to that. But even then, gradually over time, he left that. And there were lyrics said in the music he was producing that he knew his mother wouldn't approve of. But because they'd paid their money, he was willing to go along with it. Start examining your own life. Take a look at it and say, okay, are there things in here that I would want my mother to know about? You know, are you willing to have the newspaper talk about it, write about it? And if your answer to that is no, I wouldn't, well, then what are you doing? And what kind of life are you leading? And what kind of legacy are you leaving behind? And what kind of influence are you having on the people around you? Have this be your wake-up moment, where just like Canton, you say, this isn't the life I want to live. And don't be like him to say, okay, well, I'm going to go out and make my money, and then I'll give money to the church, and that'll make it all right. It's not going to make it right. Jesus didn't die for your money. He died for you. And he loves you. And he wants you to live the life that would be pleasing to him. As a Christian, and all we do and say, it's to be to the honor of him, not to the honor of ourselves. And, you know, it's a very Kansas story is a very universal story. You know, somehow or other, we think in young adulthood, we know what we're doing, and we got this thing together, and we can live our life based on our own terms. But wake up and understand, no, that's not the way. That's not the truth. And that's not the life. And that's not the legacy you want to leave behind. In all that we do or say, let it be pleasing to Him. And if you need a turnaround, you can do exactly what Kat did. Do that. Say, this isn't me. This doesn't fit me. This isn't what I want to be. And turn and change. And realize this, that a broken and contrite spirit, God will no wise reject. He won't cast out. He will accept you and say, okay, you're mine. You're back into my company now. You're part of my family now. And realize the story of the prodigal son was written for you to let you know that you can always come home. You can always have that forgiveness. You can have the joy of your salvation once again. All you have to do is turn and say, this is what I want to do with my life. I want to live my life in honor to Him, pleasing to Him, and I'm going to trust Him to put everything else into alignment, that He'll work all the things together for my good, even my mistakes. Realize He's powerful enough to even work your sin back together so that you can be with Him for all eternity. He's willing to cover it, forgive it, forget it, and put it away so that you can be with Him. If you want someone to pray with you, I believe in this verse. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If you were raised Christian and for whatever reason you went away, even if as an adult you made a decision and then for whatever reason you decided, I know what I'm doing with my life, I get to run it again, and you want to turn back and come back, now's the day. Let today be the day of your salvation, where you come back and say, I want to be forgiven. I want to be set free from this. Numbers toll free, 888-777-1999. Don't need to leave your name. Don't need to tell us who you are. If there are things separating you from God today, today get rid of them. Today put your life back on the right track. Don't wait for tomorrow, because tomorrow may not come. Today. Do it. Get right with God. Well, up next, meet a woman who feeds 1,000 children every day and hear about her dream to also provide them housing. All of that when we come back.
I started feeling pain between my spine and my shoulder blade. All I had was pain and no relief. There was a sizable mass consistent with a malignant cancer in upper right lung. And that's complex, that's tough stuff. I was walking, talking, but I didn't know how sick I was.
I remembered seeing the ad for Cancer Treatment Centers of America, and I thought, this is the place he needs to be.
To find out more about Cancer Treatment Centers of America and our unique treatment options for complex and advanced stage cancer, go to cancercenter.com. You'll be able to see our treatment results for many types of cancers and how they compare to national averages. You can also check for participating insurance plans.
The game plan was chemotherapy and radiation throughout the whole period. It was an aggressive plan of attack. I liked that.
We gave him chemotherapy and radiation. He was an amazing patient. He tolerated treatment exceptionally well.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America is different. You feel it the moment you call or walk into one of our hospitals. It's state-of-the-art medicine, unique treatment options, and a level of compassion that cannot be copied. Why? Our people. People who give you not only their expertise, but their humanity, and the most thoughtful, well-organized, patient-centered care you'll find anywhere.
My strength came back. I began to become myself again.
George does have his life back now. He has a life that I never thought he was gonna have.
With the teamwork, the treatment plans, the facilities, the combination of all the aspects of the treatment, I'm so happy that I went to CTCA.
Every minute counts when you're fighting complex or advanced stage cancer. So please call or visit cancercenter.com today. Appointments are available now. Cancer Treatment Centers of America. Care that never quits.
What is wrong with you?
I hate you.
Easier than that. You just don't know what to do.
Being a foster or adoptive parent can be very difficult. I know. I've been there. That's why Orphans Promise developed Adoption and Foster RX, Solutions for Wounded Families. In this DVD series, parenting experts take on the tough issues and offer proven strategies. Don't miss this vital information. Call now, because there is hope for wounded families.
In today's economy, feeding a few children can stretch every family's budget. But in South Africa, we met a woman who feeds 1,000 children. Every single day.
Thousands of AIDS orphans live in Bush Buck Ridge, South Africa. Anna Temba wanted to help them, so 10 years ago she founded Ebenezer Care Center. It started out as a feeding station, but thanks to Orphans Promise, it's now home to a dozen kids. Still, every day, Anna feeds nearly 1,000 hungry children. When Anna opened the center, the South African government didn't offer any support, so she didn't know how she'd keep going.
Then God said, come CBN. CBN is helping these children to eat.
Fresh vegetables are grown in greenhouses provided by Orphans Promise.
This is our extended kitchen. This is beautiful. CBN, praise his holy name, Terry. Praise his holy name.
Through the help of Orphans Promise, even more children will soon be able to live here full-time. During our visit, construction was wrapping up on a brand new dormitory. Anna hopes one day to provide a home for hundreds of children here. She knows with God's help, nothing is impossible.
My dream, through God's power, is to see this place helping the children to learn, number one, to know about God, but because that is the first priority on earth. When they come here, they just change. As it says, John 16, God so loved the world, we are loved. So what I'm expecting here is children to know, boys and girls, to know that I am loved.
We want the children of the world to know that they're loved, and we want to help people just like Anna who say, yeah, I want to receive them. I want to be a blessing to them. If you're a member of the 700 Club, you're part of that. You're part of that wonderful outreach to the orphans in South Africa. And it's not just there. We're reaching out to help orphans around the world in over 50 countries through Orphans Promise. If you're not a member of the 700 Club, we invite you to join with us. All you got to do is call a toll-free number, 888-777-1999. Just say, yes, I want to be a member of the 700 Club. How much is it? Just $20 a month, 65 cents a day, and you join with tens of thousands of people that want to make a difference in the world today, that want to help people, and help people in very tangible ways. And if you want to designate your gift to Orphans Promise so that it goes exclusively to help orphans and single parents and families around the world, all you have to do is say, I want to give to Orphans Promise. There's also a place on CBN.com where you can give there. And when you say that, also ask for Pledge Express, electronic monthly giving. Bank does all the work. There are no checks to write. And you're assured that every single month, your gift will go to help those who are in need. Be part of it. Call us, 888-777-1999. Well, up next, a jet ski accident leaves a 12-year-old boy severely injured.
I see my son-in-law lifting my son out of the water. His neck was torn open, and you could tell it was really deep, and there were bubbles coming out, and you could hear the air, and there was blood.
The miracle that saved this boy from decapitation. All that when we come back.
If your marriage is in crisis or just needs a little boost, you're not alone. Modern families face so many challenges, they can all take the focus off your relationship. But there are ways to get your marriage back on track and turn it around. Pastor and author Philip Wagner has been married 28 years and shares the secret to a stronger marriage. How to turn your marriage around in 10 days. on the 700 Club next.
If you're the mother of a child with behavior problems, I'd like to talk to you. My name is Janet Lehman, and I'm a behavioral therapist and a mom. I know what it's like when the child that you love becomes a defiant, out-of-control child who disrespects you.
That's why my husband James and I created the Total Transformation, the program that tens of thousands of moms are now using to turn around their child's behavior.
If you've heard about the Total Transformation and wondered if it will work for you, now you can try it for free. I'm willing to give away 1,000 programs today for free.
All you need to do is get the program and let us know how it works for you. We'll let you keep it for free.
I know the Total Transformation works because I used these techniques with my own son and with troubled kids for over 30 years. Let me prove to you that it works by giving you the program free.
Call the number on your screen now to get the Total Transformation free.
Josiah Lamb is just 12 years old, and he's already been in the presence of angels. His extraordinary experience happened 4 years ago. It's a day that he and his family will never forget.
My name is Josiah Lamb, and I am 12 years old. I got into this tragic jet ski accident. I heard God's voice, and he said, "Put your hand up, Josiah."
On that 4th of July weekend, when we were at my sister's, they were just having a great time. They always did water sports. So he and my son-in-law were on the jet ski together.
And I was driving it, and so I was in the front. I just started gunning it, like I was gonna like whip it and spin. There was this blue boat line where you tie your boat up to. And we were going back and we just went straight into it.
I was upstairs in the house and all of a sudden I just hear a lot of commotion.
A few seconds before we hit it, like the sky just lit up and the time just froze. It was amazing. And the sky just lit up with angels. The angels were not no Cupid little angels that were like fluttering around with like the bow and arrows. They had flaming swords and they were just like humongous. Like they were like some brute strength guys. They were big. I heard God's voice and he said, "Put your hand up, Josiah."
I see my son-in-law lifting my son out of the water and he was just very limp. You know, you could tell it was serious. And my husband was over there at that point, and he just had Josiah, you know, with his head on his lap. You know, his neck was torn open, and you could tell it was really deep, and there were bubbles coming out, and you could hear the air, and there was blood. It was just really, really scary right at that moment. And my husband was just reassuring him the whole time.
And he said, "Josiah, don't worry about it. Everything will be okay."
And that was just because it was very chaotic. And for him to speak that peace at that moment was just really needed. They had to put him in, you know, a coma for 24 hours until the swelling came down, because if they didn't, his airway was shut.
Guy broke two fingers. This is all scar tissue now.
They told us Josiah had lifted his hand at the last second, and they said that, you know, when the rope hit his fingers and his arm, that if he wouldn't have lifted his hand, it would have gone right into his neck and it would have decapitated him.
Yeah, even though this was cut open and I broke a couple fingers, I'm happy that I'm still alive.
Well, for the first 4 days in the hospital, he couldn't speak.
When they came in one day, my mom was with me, and I was like, "Mom." She was like, "You can talk now." I was like, "Yeah, hey, I saw angels."
And I knew right then when he said that, and he started telling me he heard God's voice. When he told me that, I was just like, wow.
God was there. Like, that's the first time I ever heard God's voice, and that saved my life. When I got out of the hospital, I mean, I was just telling everybody my story. From that moment on, people wanted me to pray for them.
He just would lay hands on the kids, and he was very bold in his prayer, and he was speaking things that God was showing him.
There was a mission trip coming up to Baltimore, and I saw this guy in a wheelchair. He was just wheeling by in his wheelchair, and he was homeless. I walked over to him. I was like, we have to pray for him. So I walked over to him, and I just started praying. The first time he could move his legs, I was like, I mean, that's cool. I like that. But God, can we make him walk? Let's just make him walk. The third time I prayed for him, he got out of the chair and he could walk. Like, I was like, oh!
And my husband even went to the youth pastor and said, you know, we don't understand what's going on. And he said, look, people are getting healed. When he goes up there and gives a word and prays for people, they're getting touched and moved on by God. And he's like, this is real.
Before I got into the jet ski accident, I mean, I knew there was a God up there. All I thought God was like a judge. You're done, go to hell. That's all I thought God was, and he wasn't that very nice. He is more than that. God loves me so much, and he doesn't want his children to die, so he came down and he saved me.
It's been really cool as his mom to see that, you know, God came off the pages of the Bible and became really real in his life, and it's interactive.
God came off the pages of the Bible. I love that. And it's interactive. The Bible is just a signpost for us. It's a written record of God's communication, first with Abraham, and then with his descendants, and then the promise of the Messiah, that Jesus would come, that he would make things right. He would provide a way for you and I to get access to God Almighty. Don't put God off on a throne somewhere. Realize he's Emmanuel. He is God with us. And that record laid down in the Bible is a roadmap so that you and I can have the same access. I believe that if we do the same things that people did in the Bible, we'll get the same results. All we have to do is believe. Now, let Josiah's story be an encouragement to you. Because the Bible says that God has put his angels charge over us, that we shouldn't, lest we slip and our foot would hit a stone. He's given his angels charge over us. And just as his angels guarded Josiah to keep him from being decapitated, that same guard is over you. And because it's plural, you've got more than one. You have angels guarding you. So we're going to pray, but first we're going to get into our chat room. We've got some wonderful chat requests. Here's Teresa saying, my sister is battling with cancer for the third time. The tumors in her brain are gone, but the mass in her lung has grown. She's having a CAT scan done today. Please pray for God to remove it supernaturally. We've also got Margaret in the chat room saying, please pray for my daughter, Michelle. She has lesions on her brain, symptoms of MS, and we want to pray. We want to believe God, and that God will send his angels. God will send his son, Jesus. God will send his word and heal our disease. We want to believe. So join with us. Let's get a great circle of prayer in the chat room with all the viewing audience, and let's agree and pray and let God do the rest. Lord, we lift up these people to you that are struggling for the sister with cancer and the mass. We just speak to that mass now, be gone in Jesus' name. For the daughter with lesions on the brain, symptoms of MS, be healed and be restored and be renewed. For those crying out for healing, send your angels, Lord. Send your healing. Speak to them. Be with them. Be God off the pages of the Bible into their lives, moving and working supernaturally. Be God, Emmanuel, God with us, in us, all around us. And stretch forth your hand to do wonders now. And in faith, we say to them, be healed and be made whole in the name of Jesus. We always rejoice in praying for you. If you need prayer, call us, 888-777-1999. I'll leave you this word from Corinthians. As the Spirit of the Lord works within us, we become more and more like him and reflect his glory even more.